Backwards in the ACC, Shane Larkin, son of Hall of Fame shortstop Barry Larkin, and Durant Scott. Larkin can bury a three in addition to feed Larkin and Scott a slasher up front. Reggie Johnson has been absolutely unstoppable. Had a double-double against UMass on December 1st on our air. UCF, a new look this year in the backcourt. Calvin Newell, a transfer from Oklahoma, playing in only his third game for the Knights up front. It's all about Keith Clanton. Averaged 22.5 points a game in two games last week. Conference Player of the Week, 18 of 21 from the floor in those two games. How about that? For his head coach, national championships alongside Coach Donovan in Gainesville. Rick Crawford, Rick Hartzell, Selton Steen, the officials tonight. Time now for the opening tip brought to you by Bud Light. Here we go. Canes visiting Greens. UCF and the home goals. Kaji, Keith Clanton jumper up, and here's Newell. First possession, UCF to start our game tonight.
Miami starts out in man-to-man, which they play most of the time.
Isaiah Sykes off for Clanton. He'll pull up from 10 off the glass. Johnson a hand on the rebound. Here's Larkin. And Shane Larkin, a speedy sophomore. And one of the top guards in the ACC. First half-court possession for the visitors.
Well, Miami now go inside out. Get it to the big guy. Better get him involved in the game early.
With 10 to shoot, Larkin pulls up. The mark on a three, but Johnson has his first of what Canes fans hope is many rebounds tonight. Larkin, the kick out. McKinney Jones, long range shot is good. It's a three for Trey McKinney Jones, who missed this morning's shoot around with the flu. Stayed at the team hotel here in Orlando and was doubtful right up until tip. He was getting some fluids and hanging out in the locker room, and apparently he's just fine. Newell with a penetration too hard. Clinton cleans up down low. First two for the preseason Conference USA Player of the Year.
Nice job. All the defense converged on the driver, and Clanton was free to tap it in.
Donnie Jones told us this morning one thing Keith has gotten better at, and this is senior season, is finishing up around the basket. Larkin backdoor cut. Easy two on a feed from Kaji. And the first two of the night for Shane Larkin.
Shane Larkin's having an outstanding sophomore campaign, Dave. He's scoring, he's defending, shooting threes. Terrific player.
Tristan Spurlock, transfer from Virginia, off for Newell, long range shot. Woo, it's way off. Johnson, one-handed, tiptoes the baseline and saves it. Newell, the transfer from Oklahoma, played a few games last year for the Sooners and had the one-year mandatory sit-out on the transfer from the Big 12. He has been very much up and down, and this is third game as a Knight. Long time to sit out a whole year. Johnson aggressive. Wilson a piece of that good defense. Plant. Sykes the slasher. Runs into trouble. Larkin read that pass beautifully. Shane Larkin on the move. Feeds Kaji for the finish. Kenny Kaji, emphatic stuff. And look at Miami's great start on the road.
Very smart by Larkin. Big guy runs the court. Give him the ball. Otherwise, he won't run, Dave, next time.
Miami 3-5 early. Sykes hangs. Very difficult shot. Tries to foul the miss. Durant's got a hand on it. Johnson, look at the outlet pass. McKinney Jones. He is running. Gets by the defense. Misses Kaji. The trailer. The finish and a timeout for Donnie Jones. He's seen enough, thank you. UCF needs to talk it over. What a start for Miami. A 9-2 Canes lead. And it's a bit of a free-for-all, kind of like Penn State football in a way. Players could go wherever they wanted without penalty. Some left, including three would-be starters. But Keith Clanton, the star, stayed. Newell off again on the three. And Johnson has another rebound early.
He just pushed Clanton to the side, Dave. He's so strong and physical. He got that rebound.
292 pounds worth of strength, Pete. And four rebounds early for Reggie Johnson. He had 19 and 13 and six blocks against UMass when we saw him last time. McKinney Jones on the skip. Way long on three. Kaji, nice save at the baseline. And here's Durant Scott.
You can't give Miami second shot.
Johnson for three! Are you kidding? Johnson His first three of the season. He's 1 for 5 from long range. We spoke with Reggie this morning after the shoot around. We said, can you shoot from long range, Reggie? He said, sure, I can hit a three, and he did it. That was for you, Pete. Platt trying to answer a big man. Can't hit. And here's Larkin with a rebound, and Miami is just completely owning the Knights early here.
We're on fire.
Wow.
UCF's got to get a stop, get out in transition.
Kaji got caught. Johnson trying to find the handle in the paint. Look at Larkin, he's everywhere. For Kaji, baseline. Rattles out. Johnson, weak side rebound. So strong.
Wow.
No offensive foul and 2 for Reggie Johnson. He's got 5 early points and 5 rebounds early.
Big advantage for Miami. The referees are letting a lot go, Dave. They're bigger, stronger, more physical. So it's a big advantage for Miami if they let them play like this.
Newell trying to get going. High off the glass. He hits a very difficult shot. The Sooner transfer, Calvin Newell's got his first bucket. The junior from Philadelphia.
UCF goes to a 2-3 zone, Dave. They're going to change defense a lot. They have no answer for Reggie Johnson, so they're going to try to pack it in around him. Miami shoots threes pretty well, but they got to take a chance. I like the defense by UCF.
Larkin trying to zone bust that with a long range three, and he does it. How about Shane Larkin? Give him 5. Second triple of the night here for Miami already, and they are shooting the lights out. 7 of 12, 58% foul down low. And we've got a break. And UCF needs a break because the big guy coach can shoot a three. Reggie Johnson, are you serious? First three. Casey leads Conference USA in three-point shooting this year. 13 of 21 for a sophomore from outside Tampa, Florida. He'll have one more.
Dave, if I'm UCF, I'm going to press a little bit. I got to get our defense to get our offense going. A little pressure, back to man-to-man, that's what I would do. Right now, Miami's in a great groove offensively.
First quarter tonight for Casey Wilson. He was 1 of 4. Knights scoring a double figures in the team's last game, a win over Old Dominion, a true road game in Virginia. Miami's won 5 straight. They smashed Charlotte down at Coral Gables, previously undefeated Charlotte from the Atlantic 10. On Friday night, wasn't even close. Scott driving baseline, looks for help. Larkin, ball movement, McKinney Jones. Johnson up top. Bounce pass, Scott back door, and a lay-in for Durant Scott's first 2 of the game.
Great pass by Reggie Johnson. Terrific. He's doing it all day. Threes, post moves, rebound, blocking shots, dropping dimes.
Unbelievable. 5 points, 5 rebounds, and an assist. Clanton baseline. Nice reverse layup. Keith Clanton with an answer. That 14 for 15 field goal game against Bethune-Cookman had a career best 30 points, couple games back for Keith Plant. It has been very tough to stop for defenses. Had 15 against Old Dominion in the team's last game, but limited that night by foul trouble. 18 to shoot here for the Canes. Larkin lost that home.
Reggie does a great job passing the ball. Nice dime inside to Durant Scott. Terrific. He's doing it all. Another angle from our crack crew. Perfect pass, nice finish. I think Durant Scott was shocked he got such a great pass from the big fella.
Last subs in the game, that includes Tanya Jacuri. He's a true freshman big man from Hialeah, Florida, outside Miami, 7 feet tall. Larkin under 10 to shoot, hangs, blocked away by Clanton. The all-time rejection leader in UCF history, heading into his senior year, adds to the total.
Tyke's got to get going, Dave. Second leading scorer, Durant Scott right now is doing an excellent job defending Isaiah Sykes.
Walked into the game off the night bench, misfires, long range shot. Larkin a hand on it, stripped away by Wilson out of bounds. And Larkin and company will have it again.
Nice drive by Larkin, but a better block that time by Keith Clanton. As Dave, you said, top shot blocker in UCF history.
It is 99th straight start as a Knight. As we talked about, very interesting story. Had a chance to go to any school because of the NCAA sanctions that were passed down just before the year started. Florida State was interested, took a visit there. USC called him. Kentucky and Coach Calipari made some contact. That had to be tempting because of the first round draft pick machine that Coach Cal's become in Lexington.
Exactly. Very tempting, but he loves Orlando, loves his teammates, loves the school, and decided to stay home.
Curry up top. Works for Gamble off the Kane bench. Here's Ryan Brown, also off the pine for Jim Larranaga's team. And a whistle off the ball, a foul against Miami. Tanya Jacuri, the 7-foot freshman, has his first team second early on here in a dominant Miami game. The Canes tattooed Charlotte in their last outing, a game that wasn't even close. 77-46, Durant Scott with 16-12, had a double-double for Miami, and they have not let up since, clearly.
UCF, get it to Sykes and attack the cup.
Travels there.
He's got to get going, Dave, for UCF to have any chance. He's getting 15 a game. I think he's a terrific play, but right now he's really struggling against this excellent Miami Hurricane defense.
And Jim Larrañaga knows he's been averaging 5 assists a game. That's because Callan Newell had to sit out the year after transfer from Oklahoma of the Big 12. So in that time, Sykes and Walker off the bench, a freshman, were handling the point. Very slow start for the home team. Scott firing long range. 3 is good, Durant Scott. How about Miami here? Rushing UCF. He's got 5. 22-7. They played well. We saw them, Pete, you and I, and Amherst. They played very well against Charlotte the other night at home. Only 2 games in the month so far. Another turnover. Plant walks. A team that averages 16.5 turnovers a game. The Knights are struggling mightily on their home court on the UCF campus.
When it comes to the financial obstacles military families face,
belong to Keith Clanton until the first few minutes of this game. Reggie's been something, getting a much-deserved break here. McKinney Jones apparently is all right, battling the flu symptoms all day today. Here's Scott up top. Clanton chases him with some help.
Dave, this is a tough veteran team, Miami. They've been around a lot of seniors, veteran guys.
McKinney Jones, backdoor cut, went for the jam, but it's off the heel of the rim. And here's Sykes up high for the rebound. Newell will pull up.
That's it. That's good news now for UCF, Dave. They're starting to call a little bit. That's good. That's important. Do we see nice attack the basket? Good block inside. Way to get up, big fella. That time, Blair, the block, had a piece of that.
Stephon Blair in the game for the first time. 6'9 freshman from Fort Lauderdale for UCF. Jacuri, 2 fouls. He's to the bench. For Miami. 4 freshmen who play significantly for Donnie Jones' team. Off the bench, that's it. I mean, this is a different look, UCF squad. Really the opposite of what you're talking about with Miami. They are not experienced. Newell drives in, again too hard. Scott looks for the loose change. Athletic play as he runs right into Walker. Laquan Walker, the freshman, will commit his first foul. Looking for the loose change there, getting too aggressive.
Good hustle, loose ball. Walker went for it, but Durant Scott had to have it. Young man from Bronx, New York, played at Rice High School in Manhattan. He's a competitor and he's a veteran.
Scott's the ACC player of the week. Against Charlotte, 16 points, 12 rebounds for his first double-double. He is not an outside threat, but he does have a three-pointer today. He likes to slash and drive the basket, get fouled, and shoot the floaters. Travel on McKinney Jones, a turnover against Miami.
Dave, it's a long game. UCF's got to chip their way back into it. Right now, if I'm that, I'm trying to get Clanton going. Some pick and pops. Have him shoot a 3 or drive the ball.
First turnover of the night for Jim Larrañaga's team.
They take good care of the ball, Dave. Our game we did at UMass, we only had 9. Took care of the rock then. They only average about 12 turnovers a game, which is excellent.
Force 13 a game from opponents. Sykes, long range shot is good, just inside the arc for Isaiah Sykes. Team's second leading scorer behind Clanton. And as Pete mentioned, he has got to get going if the Knights have a chance tonight.
Got to get a stop now. UCF trying to get out in transition, Dave.
Larkin from right here in Orlando with the Dr. Phillips High School. Long range shot, Kaji misfires. Newell hand on the rebound. Gamble knocks it out of bounds. And a nice chat with Shane Larkin before the game today. His dad, Barry, is planning on attending. It's about a half-hour trip for the family. Barry, very busy with a lot of different duties. Recently inducted into the Hall of Fame. Tries to make every game, but his mom makes every game, including driving 3 hours from here in Central Florida to Miami, to the U campus.
Great family. I coach his uncle, Byron Larkin, at Xavier University. Scored over 2,000 points for the Musketeers, and Shane is certainly a terrific athlete also.
Great hustle. Causes the turnover there. He is everywhere. Four turnovers tonight here for the home team.
Dave, as you mentioned before, UCF averages 16 turnovers a game. It's way too many. So many young guys. The pieces are starting to come together. It's going to take a while.
Larkin, look at the speed. That's caught. The defense lays it in. He's just too quick for anyone right now on the floor for UCF. Burst through for his seventh point of the night.
Dave, he's one of the quickest players in the country. Lightning.
Foot speed is alarming if you're a Knight fan. Sykes has fouled before. He gets to the basket. Personal there on Gamble is first.
Larkin turns the corner with the left hand. Blows by. Nobody was even near him. Lightning quick, just like his dad. Barry, the great Hall of Famer for the Cincinnati Reds. Lightning in a bottle.
Sykes to the baseline. And junior from Detroit, whose numbers have skyrocketed in his first couple seasons here. Clanton is bumped on the baseline. And he's got to become a factor quickly here, Pete, if the Knights want to think comeback.
Exactly. Did a nice job. He turned his face. Reggie Johnson's got bailed out. He wasn't going to make that shot. Nice move. Base spinning, wheeling, and traffic. Threw a prayer up. Yep. That's the matchup that UCF wants. They want the big guy Reggie. Try to get in foul trouble. They get the big guy a second foul. Coach Larinaga will probably sit him. So that's important. Keep going at Reggie Johnson. Try to get him another foul.
Fouls on Kaji there, Coach. That's
oh,
his first.
Okay. Yeah. Reggie Johnson. My fault. But keep attacking.
Clanton hits the second. Keith, a criminal justice major here at UCF, is on track to get his degree. He told us before the game, yeah, Florida State was tempting. He thought about FSU. USC and Kentucky were not really in the mix. And Donnie Jones, the head coach, said to us today, wanted to make it his choice. And Keith came back, wanted to stick with his teammates, try to win a regular season championship. Johnson, can he get another three? No, way short. Raises the front iron this time. And Wilson, with good hustle, helps knock that out of bounds. Is this for us? I mean, Reggie's trying two threes here. He was only 0 for 4 to begin the season. We brought it up this morning.
We talked to him. We said, Reggie, can you make an outside shot?
I was skeptical.
You live in the low post. You dominate. I said, why do you stay? He says, that's where the money is. I'll make my money one day in the pros. But he wants to be versatile.
Here's Clanton. Reggie said he'd never faced Keith in a game until tonight, but knows a lot about him watching film and reading about Keith Clanton. Newell, Wilson, long range threat, partially blocked. Kaji came out, got a piece. Really nothing going well for UCF's offense in the half court. You said it. Top of the broadcast. Canes are an NCAA caliber team. I'm a believer, no question. Johnson down low. And one big reason is the big guy. Nearly 300 pounds worth. Reggie Johnson. He's got seven.
Let the big dog eat. Get him involved in the game, then he'll play defense, he'll rebound, he'll block shots.
Sykes hang, it was partially blocked. Reggie might have got a piece of that. Larkin running, lobbing to Brown, just too tall for Ryan Brown to bring that in. And when we come back, UCF gets it back. Reggie Johnson.
He's an outstanding coach.
Five NCAA bids, 13 postseason bids in all. Great one to Bowling Green prior to George Mason. Sykes hangs. Too strong. Kaji handled the rebound. Out for Newell. He'll pop a three. Short. Kenny Jones. Strong defensive glass. Here come the Canes.
They have so much experience. And they play great defense. That's the thing. You give teams only 61 points a game. The whole team with 38% from the field. So the defense is terrific. Their offense is excellent.
Johnson can't corral the high-low play from Kaji. Turnover back to the Knights. Sykes. Nice through traffic. And he's bumped on the way to the basket. They call him Zeke. He's from Detroit. Big Isaiah Thomas fan. That's Isaiah's nickname. And Sykes loves those Pistons.
Sykes is very talented. He attacks the cup. That's what you got to do. Nice pump fake. Talk about the Pistons. Chuck Daly was famous for that violent pump fake, Dave. We talk about that, you and I. You brought
Speaking
it up to
of
me
the
at
Pistons.
Lunch. The Pistons, yep. He did a nice job. That pump fake, and that's what he's got to do. They got to keep attacking the basket. They're not making threes, Dave. 0-4 on three-point shots right now, so they got to keep driving and try to get Miami into foul trouble.
Fouls on Kaji. Speaking of foul trouble, his second, so he's out. Eric Swope will come in the game for the first time. With Kaji saddled with those two personals. Sykes hits the second. Freshman year, scoring 4 points a game. Now a junior, 15.5 points a game for Sykes. He could have been the most improved player in the conference last year.
No question. As you mentioned, he went 4 points as a freshman, Dave, and three rebounds. Then he had 12 points, rather, as a sophomore, six rebounds, now 15 points. So he's really terrific.
Market. Controls just over 10 to shoot. He'll pull up. That's a two-pointer just inside the arc for Shane Larkin. He's got nine. That leads the Canes. Glenn will try to respond. Vacon Johnson drives baseline. Too strong, though. Glenn fights hard. And the stick back, as Coach Jones said. He and Keith in the offseason looked at a lot of film and realized a lot of points were left off the board on missed stick back layups, just like that. So he's converting this year. Nice improvement from junior to senior year for him. Scott pulls up. Way too strong. Almost got a nice break off the glass. Here's Walker. He's bumped by Duransko.
See, Durant Scott going after Walker. Too much hands. It's the seventh foul, Dave. Now 1-1, so it's important. Get back in the game. UCF has to keep attacking the basket, and they got to make their free throws. Unfortunately, they only shoot 61% from the foul line. They got to do a much better job from the foul line.
17 foul, so Walker, the freshman from Philly. With only one scholarship senior, that's Clanton. A miss there for Walker. McKinney Jones has the rebound. UCF is the 10th youngest team in the country in terms of seniors on the roster. McKinney Jones pulls up. A little short. Looks for the rebound. Clack. Finds it in the paint.
Dave, if they can get this score under 10 by halftime, that'll be a big plus for the Knights.
Good shot, Matt.
Williams with a miss. Matt Williams. UCF freshman. Things get physical down low as Wilson and Johnson collide. And Casey Wilson picks it up. That'll be his first foul.
Shot goes up, boom. He ran into a big three. Reggie Johnson.
It's not easy to knock Reggie over.
No, he's like a battleship, Dave. These little small boats.
I like that. The battleship. That could be his nickname. Is it too late to give him a nickname as a senior, you know?
He had any nickname he wants tonight, the way he's playing.
Can Reggie make it in the NBA? What do you think?
Boy, I tell you, he's still got to lose some weight, I think, Dave, to get up and down. But I think he can, the way he's playing, his touch, his strength. The more I see him, the more I like him.
Yeah, me too. It's your second time seeing him live. Kenny Jones a fake. Another 20 to shoot. Just a little five to go in our first half. It's been all Canes. Reggie, right low block, is stripped on the way up, and he'll shoot some free throws. Good help defense, low block for UCF, going to be Sykes.
Reggie Johnson has more moves than a can of worms in a low post. Nice spin, got double, but went through it, got fouled. Putting on a clinic. Tough guy to guard. You have to double him, Dave, as soon as he catches it. Can't wait.
Already thinking about a double-double in the first half here. He's got 944 career points, Pete. He'll be the 34th, as he adds to the total, in Canes history to get 1,000. The signature victory for the Canes this year against Michigan State at home. Get a double-double. 10 and 11 against Tom Izzo's Spartans. And this kind of victory, whenever Charlotte could be a Turner team, these build the resume. They won at UMass. Florida Gulf Coast, the only loss, kind of a mysterious road game setback for him.
That was without Durant Scott, their emotional leader. He's very, very talented. They just weren't ready to play, though. Still should have won that game.
Clint. Runner gets a roll. Nine for Clinton now to go along with five rebounds.
Got to get some stops now. Able to stop there. Well, Miami keep going inside to the big fella.
On cue, Reggie Johnson doesn't get a roll this time, and the ball is stopped. Which means a possession arrow situation pointing to Miami with a fresh 35. Since that one loss we talked about, Miami's won five straight for Coach Larinaga. And he feels confident they can make a big run. It's a program that won at Duke last year and beat Florida State.
Exactly. In that game, our man, Reggie Johnson, had 27 points, 14 rebounds. He was unbelievable. Great win at Duke. I was 0 for life against Duke in that building.
Duke is Duke.
Pretty special there. We beat him a couple times at home in Virginia. We won a couple day, but
here's Ryan Brown.
It helped get Mike Krzyzewski into the Hall of Fame. The way he played me.
Had to bring up the Leave It to Beaver line. I mean, come on.
Yeah, I try to keep that quiet.
All-time great TV moments. There's Williams misfiring long-range three. And Johnson a rebound. What a story Matt Williams is. Suffering from a burst appendix while he was here during a workout. Said he wasn't feeling well. Had to be rushed to the hospital. Then had an ensuing infection. Coach spent 2 weeks in the hospital. Larkin hits, but a whistle first. We'll sort it out when we return to Orlando. It is all Miami on the road for Coach Larinaga.
Not enough help. Next leading scorer is Sykes with only four. So, but credit Miami's defense, Dave. They hold teams to 61 points a game and 38% from the field. So Miami's a terrific team, but a big part of that is their great defense.
Offensive foul call on the Canes as Larkin gets physical, driving toward the 10. Miami outscores teams by about 11.5 points a game coming in. That's the first on Shane Larkin. Good defense by Tristan Spurlock, the transfer from Virginia, one of Pete's old stops. He's from Woodbridge near Washington, D.C.
I don't think Brown could guard Isaiah Sykes, so I get the ball to Sykes, clear, let him drive.
Newell, tracked down by Larkin, 50 to shoot here for the home team. Johnson, good hustle. Blanton gets by him. Contact. Offensive foul.
Good help by Miami. They know when Clinton gets it, he's going to put the ball on the deck, so a lot of help to get by his man, but good help. That time, McKinney Jones stepped in, took the charge.
First foul on Keith Glamp. Game this game with 176 career blocks, number one all-time in Knight history. May go down as the all-time great UCF player. Jeremiah Taylor had a great career here. On route to the NBA. Jermaine Taylor, excuse me, but Glamp, four-year player, has been something.
Terrific. As you mentioned before, he leads the UCF all-time history in block shots. And he'll be up there before it's done, Dave, in rebounds and points.
Under 10 to shoot. Larkin had that partially blocked. And Newell's got the loose change. Gets physical and is fouled on the way up. Sykes going to tie the shoe and make sure he's all right, which apparently he is.
Larkin gets by his man, but great help. Nice block inside. Terrific job in pushing it. Clanton came down hard after that block shot. But now the UCF's got to make their free throws, Dave. As you mentioned before, only 61% coming into the game.
Newell just 1 for 2 on the year coming in. Only playing his third game, as we talked about, the transfer from Oklahoma. He played for the Sooners. And Coach Krueger for five games last year, averaged 13 points a game, then left transferring to UCF. Sat out the first six games this year. And as Coach Jones told us today, in his first game back after sitting out a year, when he was passing, he should have been shooting. When he was shooting, he should have been passing. Things weren't quite in sync
right
for Calvin Newell.
Well, he's a guy that really has an instinct to score. It's like I call him a point scorer. All teams to 38% from the field. They can score inside, outside. Terrific backcourt with Larkin and Durant Scott. Inside, they got the trees. Outstanding coach and Jim Larinaga. They got all, I think, the ingredients to have a great run in the big dance.
Mark that down, everybody. Maybe the lead A team here.
Travel call on Gamble in the paint. 10 turnovers. I'll make it 5 each. 10 total. First half.
You see, too many turnovers. UCF 5, Miami 5, but UCF averages 16 turnovers a game. Way too many, Dave.
Travel call on Clanton, and the ball was knocked aside. Keith cannot believe that call. Sometimes a senior and the preseason player of the year in Conference USA would get that call, but not tonight.
Well, going up against a big-time team in Miami, so they're going to get a lot of respect.
Keith's got the beard going. And we asked Keith before the game about it. Are you mistaken for James Harden? He said, yeah. Actually, quite a bit. Houston Rocket star. But he likes it. It was not after Harden. There's a traveling call again. Gamble walks. And a turnover. Kind of a fear of the beer type thing here.
Well, it looks pretty impressive to me, Dave. But once again, you got to worry about getting food today. Right? If you're hungry and you know you eat some food.
Is that why you don't don a beard even in the wintertime?
No,
pretty cold in Shroudsville.
I got no skills with my beard. No skills.
And a 15 and counting first half. Miami impressive. Newell, a fake, drives baseline, needs help. Gets it to freshman Walker. Couple of Philly products. Dennis shoot here for the Knights. Sights, slashes. Skips the Spurlock. With 5 to shoot, Tristan Spurlock pulls up. Get it. From 10, loose change. Who's got it? Larkin again. McKinney Jones, long range. 3 is good again. Ray McKinney Jones, a couple of triples. His career best came against Michigan State. That huge win against Sparty for Miami early in the year. Signature victory for them. Spurlock, a response. A 3 for Tristan. First points of the night for him, his 10th 3 of the season. Shot clock turned off. Could be the final possession of our first half. Here's Larkin with 5 seconds. And it's dribbled off a leg there on Sykes, 4.1. Seconds remaining in the opening 20 here tonight from Orlando.
Right now, UCF has a foul to give, Dave. They've only committed 5, so a guy like Walker, maybe Newell can give one. Just don't want to give him a basket at the end, because right now they're down 14, so something to think about.
Dylan Carell will come in for the first time, 6'11", 225-pound freshman from North Miami Beach. Defensive substitution for Coach Jones in the final moments of the half. Scott to inbound. Brown, little curl play, lays it out the glass, Ryan Brown. Decide inbound play to perfection from Miami to end the first half. And how about that bust for UCF on defense? And Ryan Brown, using the pick, loops around, lays it in for a second field goal of the opening half.
Great coaching that time by Jim Larrañaga. Durant Scott.
First time since this arena opened in 2007, hosting an ACC team. Only one win all time for the Knights against Miami. That was in 2010, the same year they started 14-0 and beat Florida before Conference USA play started. But they stumbled once the league slate opened and just made the CBI. Clint, right low block, can't hit the runner. And the rebound, Kanji. He'll hand back to Durant Scott.
Yeah, that time he got bumped a little bit. I tell you, the officials were a big key to the end. These guys are doing a great job, but they're letting a lot go. Big advantage, Miami, because they're physical, they're veterans, they're seniors. So it really helps them. This young team from UCF, Dave's not ready for the physicality of this game.
The entire bench for the Knights, freshman. It's a young team. Johnson in the paint. Kick out, Scott, long range shot in the corner, back iron, Kanji offensive glass, battles the runner in the lane, can't hit, and Wilson clears a defensive rebound for UCF.
You got to push it, Dave, try to score before Miami's defense gets set.
Spurlock, ball moving, misfires on a 3, Larkin couldn't find the rebound, Sykes does, nifty dish down low, Clinton, the flush. Finish 11 for Keith Clinton.
Amazing, Dave. Right now, UCF is 1 for 10, 10% from three-point land. They led the country with 44% coming into the game. So credit Miami's defense once again.
Clint, five double-doubles in his first eight games this year. He has been tough. At 7 in 33 games a year ago. Numbers, UCF coach, one of the top three-point shooting teams in the nation. Really struggling in that opening half.
1 for 9, Dave. Now 1 for 10, 30% from the field. And right now, Miami's playing a great game. But the first 4 or 5 minutes of the second half are key. So if UCF can get a little spurt, this game is not over.
Tops in the nation coming in three-point shooting at 44.1%. And the only Knight to hit a three so far, Tristan Spurlock, in the first half. Larkin gets physical. Step back on Clinton. Rattles out. Johnson, another rebound. Blocked away by Wilson. Well, foul call down low.
Larkin comes off the pick and roll. In and out. The big fella goes up. Looked pretty good to me. UCF guys did not get their money's worth, Dave, on that one.
Foul's called on Sykes, his second. Look at how close Reggie Johnson is, the double-double. High arcing free throw into double figures in scoring. Third active rebounder in the ACC. Heading into play this week, 11 points for him tonight. Mason Plumlee of Duke, the leader, over 800 boards. Reggie now up to 727 career rebounds. He has become a force in the ACC. Sykes the lefty, slashing what he likes to do, but he can't finish. Too long. Back iron. Scott at the free throw line has the rebound. Grant Scott outside the paint. Kaji. Big mismatch here on Newell. He's got several inches on him. Trying to take advantage. Baseline runner, but it's too strong. Spurlock the rebound. UCF on the move.
You got to score in transition, Dave, before the big guy gets down there.
Just like that on cue. Sykes, chance for a three-point play.
Run, baby, run if you're UCF. But attack the cup. Nice job. Excellent finish by Isaiah Sykes. Bounce pass by Spurlock. That's what they got to do, Dave. I'd love to see them press a little bit. I know they're not a great pressing team, UCF, but come after a little. Be aggressive. Take swings. Don't be the richest guy in the graveyard, you know? Be,
you got to fight, right?
Be aggressive, yes.
McKinney Jones picked up that foul, coach. Sykes up to 7 points now tonight. Completes a three-point play. Ooh. The fans sense a little comeback here. School's not in session. They're on holiday break here at UCF, but still a nice turnout tonight. If this is during the school session, this place would be completely packed, overflowing with students.
I double him, double him.
Johnson spins and scores. 13 on the night for Reggie.
Got to double him, Dave. He's too tough down there. Got a great touch, excellent feet.
Clinton long range three. Wide left. And Scott has the board. Durant Scott on the move. That's his game. He'll pull up from 17 and hit Durant Scott. What a stroke. He's got 7 on the night.
Dave, he's one of the best guards in the ACC, Durant Scott. He's the emotional leader, playing unbelievable defense, can score, leading scorer for the Hurricanes coming into the season.
12 straight games and double figures for Scott, coach, heading in this one tonight. Missed the first three games due to NCAA sanctions. Some impermissible benefits, but his return to the team played very well. Missed there from Sykes. Here's Scott. Hangs in some contact.
Miami Dave could go inside, outside. They got all the answers to make a great run. Can score inside, outside. Get it to the big fella. The big dog eats.
Florida in the winter, isn't it?
It's very nice. Nice climate. Nice atmosphere. Everybody's laid back. Everybody's chilling out. I like it.
Put that winter coat away, my friend.
Yeah, I brought a raincoat that's lined, and I burned it. I didn't need it.
Fouls on Spurlock just before the break. Scott has one more.
Dave, talking to the Miami people today, this team rises up to the occasion. The bigger the game, the better they play. So these guys responded to the challenge here, and I think the sky's the limit, Dave, for this Miami team.
Scott closing in on double figures. Reggie Johnson already has his fourth double-double of the season. Scott, nice defensive pressure, causes the miscue.
Rand Scott, good job denying. Sykes gets a piece of it, dives on the floor, he's ready to go on. Nice job. Rand Scott's one of the best guards in the ACC, Dave. He's their leader.
You're seeing why. All ACC honorable mention last year. I'm with you, Pete. This program's got all the pieces in place for a major run this year.
Only weakness, Dave, not real deep. So foul trouble, Reggie Johnson or Kaji, somebody turns an ankle, that's the only problem. But they go six deep. And those six guys are special. Ryan Brown's one guy off the bench. But great backcourt, good inside guys, excellent defense.
Jakiri trying to beat the shot clock on the baseline. Misfires, looking for his first points of the night. Spurlock is fouled on the way up.
UCF, now what they got to do is try to keep attacking the basket off the dribble, Dave, and then a little bit of zone pressure. Soft zone pressure. Try to get Miami to think a little bit, get them a little bit out of sync. You can't just let them come down and put you in the blending machine, which they're doing right now.
And doing it effectively. That fouls on Brown. Coach, that's his second, and one more here for Spurlock. Transfer from Virginia, the ACC, has his fourth point of the night. Team best 8 rebounds in the night's last game, a win on the road at Old Dominion.
We see some pressure now, a 1-2-2, three-quarter court zone, pressed by UCF, I like it. Miami's going 2-1-2 against it, they're not trying to score, but I like that. Try to get them out of the rhythm a little bit.
Here's Larkin. Looks at the teardrop. Short this time, but has the loose chain. Baseline and finishes. How about Shane Larkin? Right place at the right time. Another Kane into double figures. He's got 11. His dad, Barry, is in attendance tonight. We are trying to locate Barry, the 12-time All-Star, just this past summer inducted into the Baseball Hall of Fame. Being a bit evasive with our cameras, we can't quite locate him, but we're going to work on that.
Yeah, sure. He's a hot commodity every place he goes, Dave, as you know. But we'd love to get him on. We've got a great crew. If our crew can't do it, can't be done.
Sunshine checks out. Barry won the 1990 World Series with the Cincinnati Reds. Johnny Damon was here at halftime as well. A little halftime ceremony. A lot of baseball royalty in the house here tonight.
Yeah, great baseball area here, Dave. The warm weather and excellent coaching.
Damon played with the Indians last year. 235 career homers and a couple of World Series wins. Under 5 to shoot for Wilson. Let's fly from 3 and buries it. Casey Wilson, as we talked about, at 62%, leading the conference in three-point shooting heading in.
Desperation, Davis. Spinning, fall away, fade away, three. They're working that game every day. They're working.
At the end of practice, right? For midcourt. Here's Ryan Brown. Kick out, Grant Scott. Floats down low, Jakiri finishes. Kanye Jakiri. And that is his first career field goal. Jakiri had just a free throw coming into this game. Flat never end, nice reverse layup with the left. Keys is up to 13, so congrats to Kanye Jakiri, the freshman at 7 feet from near Miami. First career basket tonight.
Tremendous pass by Durant Scott, Dave. Set him up, set the table, and he brought it home.
Scott fires. Long three. Look at the touch. Look at the ball going through the basket. That is an NBA stroke, everybody. 12 for Scott, second three.
He's special. Nice rotation. Everything, Dave. Unbelievable pass to Jakiri, as you mentioned, and he knocked down a 24-footer.
See how soft that went through, though? Yep, barely touched everything. Walker responds. The freshman has his 11th three of the year. And in fact, Coach, all 11 of Daquan Walker's field goals have been from three-point range this year. McKinney Jones on the red. Well, way strong. An air ball on a three try. Here's Scott. Close. Back iron, no. Gamble up high. Clinton fights hard for the rebound. Here comes UCF.
You got to push it now. They're scoring transition. Miami's too tough when you get the defense set.
Wilson is bump, leading us to a break. And the fans showing some energy. Durant Scott coming off a double-double against Charlotte. 16-12 the other night. Sweet touch from long range.
They win their first game, so be good challenges. But this team, you got to bring a helmet to play against these guys. They're tough.
Ole Miss, San Diego State, Arizona State will be out there as well at that event on the islands. These are all good pre-ACC tests. Nice drive there by Walker. And the lay-in is the freshman's first non-three-point field goal of the season.
I like this now, Davis. A little bit late, but I like zone pressure. Try to cause a little bit indecision. A double, a big guy. That's it.
Walker comes free. Listen to Coach Gillen here. Freshman pulls up, feeling it. Daquan Walker. Second three, and how about the Knights with a little comeback?
They're mixing it up now, Dave. They're not going to double the low post right away. They're going to get in a tandem outside and try to help out. So they're going to mix it up. But I like the fact that they're keeping their zone pressure up. 1-2-2, three-quarter court zone press. Miami's attacking it, Dave, with a 2-1-2, trying to get the ball to Reggie Johnson in the middle. So Miami's going to go inside. UCF's not going to double in the post.
Kaji, long range. Three is good. Kenny Kaji, that's a dagger. Tight three-pointer off of the play stoppage. And the advice from Coach Jones there. First triple of the night for Kenny Kaji. Give him 7. He had 17. And that tattoo job they had against Charlotte in their last game.
Dang it, Dave. Nice job. Transfer from Florida. Kenny Kaji. Redshirt senior. Pick and pop. Buried it. And that, he's such a great shooter, Dave. That's what he does best. Even though he's 6'10", you got to switch that screen. You can't help out because you give him an inch. That's what he loves to do. Shoot from downtown.
Sykes. Isaiah's got 9. Kaji, third team all ACC last year. He's a good one. He's got 30 points in a game this year, most for a Kane in a single outing. That was against North Carolina Greensboro.
The pressure was good. It took 12 seconds off the shot clock, so now Miami doesn't have as much time.
Kaji finds a loose ball from the elbow, back iron, can't hit. Williams a hand on it. Kaji's got it again in the lane. Runner's good. A little more Watson for Miami right now. He's up to 9. And the lead balloons back to 14.
Too physical, Dave. He's knocking him around. The ref letting a lot go, so it helps them.
Wilson on the end, back iron on the three try. Scott handling the rebound. And the Knights will have it on the baseline.
It's a good lesson for this young UCF team, Dave. You got to be physical, got to be strong. You got to get in the mud, get in the glue, and mix it up. Not tough enough. They're too nice sometimes.
Bloody Nose Lane?
Bloody Nose Lane.
Get in there.
That's next week. It's conference plays, Bloody
that's
Nose
right.
Lane.
Sykes to the left. Of course, he is a southpaw. Nice hustle on the baseline, trying to rip it from the reach of Kaji, but it's out of bounds, and the Canes get it back.
Keep the pressure on, but you got to keep the ball out of the middle. You're trying to get the ball to Reggie Johnson in the middle of the floor. Somebody's got to take that away. That's Sykes. Got to take that away. Did not take it away. He's worrying too much about Larkin.
Kaji in the corner. Nice move. Baseline stripped away. Here's Clint. Nice try to respond. Good hustle. Knocked out of his grasp. 9 straight up to go. In our second half from Orlando. Canes looking for another notch in the resume belt. Get them set for the ACC schedule. And it's a deep conference. You like 6 teams in that league to make the big dance, huh?
I think so, Dave. Now this year, for the first time, it's 18 league games, not 16. So that makes it even more difficult. When I was in the Big East, 18 games, a big difference than 16.
The freshman Walker, that long three, did everything but go in. Wilson lost it. Baseline fans vehemently disagree with the official's call. Canes have it.
Long shot, in and out.
The fans are looking on the replay video board from up above. There's the second reaction. They didn't like it the first time, Pete, and they really didn't like it in the replay.
No, looked like it might have been off Durant Scott, Dave. Getting a lot of respect, this ACC team.
Dave and Pete, former head coach at Xavier with you, USC Arena. Canes looking for a sixth straight win from the ACC, the visiting Greens here. UCF from Conference USA. Kaji, left low block, is fouled. It's physical. And Wilson challenging Kenny Kaji. Some free throws coming up here.
Johnson's excellent passer also. Backs his way in. They double. Give it inside to Kaji. He's up strong. Casey Wilson with the foul. Good call by the official.
High arcing free throw, perfect for Kaji. Shoots 77% coming in. He's into double figures. And a big game against Stetson to start the year off for Miami. A double-double, 12 and 12. And Detroit as well. Double-double, 14 points, 11 rebounds. Kaji's sort of an unsung weapon on this team. Rattles out the second free throw, but he's pretty dangerous.
He's tough. He loves that pick and pop. Set the screen and pop out, hit the three. Block shots, goes to the offensive glass. He's a very good player. Fifth-year senior, transfer from Florida.
Went baseline, Johnson, a piece of that. Blocked by Reggie Johnson. God, you scored the last 6 points for the Canes. Thinking about some more. Off the mark this time on a three. Wilson has the rebound. And it's 7 of 15 from three-point range so far. And a bump on Walker as he gets to the top of the key. Time out of the court. We'll take one as well in Orlando. Miami looking very good.
Special
player from Bronx, New York.
He's got a couple threes in double figures. Same for Larkin. He's got 11 points. Johnson already has a double-double.
It's the last chance now for UCF to make a run, Dave. They got to make a run next 3 or 4 minutes to try to get it to 10 or less.
Walker on the bounce outside the arc. Looks ready to shoot, watched by Larkin. Quentin for Wilson. Time running out. Less than 10 seconds for Quentin. Good drive and lost it. To shoot here for the home team. Sights are back. The free throw line and the shot clock.
Another example of the tenacious defense of the Miami Hurricanes. Doing on both ends of the floor, Dave.
And look who's here is Barry Larkin. Hall of Fame shortstop. It's not easy to find, Coach. Took us the entire game. We got there, though. He and his wife rarely miss son Shane in action. From right here in Orlando, Shane, as he told us today, would have at least 20 family and friends here. Went to Dr. Phillips High School, about a half an hour drive. Great Barry Larkin in the house. What a career he had. Three gold gloves. 1995 National League MVP for the Reds. McKinney Jones is bumped in the paint.
Yeah, having a good time, the family. They're up 15 points. Mom's relaxing. Barry's chilling. Life is good. Great family. As I mentioned before, coached Shane's uncle, Marvin Larkin, who was a great player at Xavier. So a wonderful family. Very well educated, really a class man.
Newell for Wilson. Drives and scores. And Casey Wilson, chance for a three-point play. Up to six for the night for Casey.
Good hustle, excellent defense. Nice steal by Walker. Push it, Newell. Nice attack in the basket. Casey Wilson. Nice pass by Newell. Excellent finish by Casey Wilson.
Third foul on Kenny Kotchi there, coach, as UCF clings to life. Just under seven to go. Still time. What do they have to do to make a comeback?
Not over. Keep the press on. Press them. You got to speed the tempo up. Keep the pressure on. Make your free throws, Dave. 61% coming into the game. You need every point you can get down. You got to make those free throws.
Wilson shoots 67%. Boy, you're right. That can really kill you when you're trying to gain some momentum and make a comeback. Can't give away those free points. Johnson back into the game. Watched by Clanton. Reggie, strong, but a foul. Contact with Clanton. And that's Keith. That is his third.
Dave, he's like a bull in a china shop. Clanton just bumping off. Just like a bull and just flies it. Is flying off. It's tough. He lost 40 pounds, Dave, since he's been at University of Miami. He lost a lot of weight. Was over 300 pounds. That was about 290.
Shoot 70% from the line coming in. We'll have one more. 18th career double-double and fourth of this season. Give him 14 points. Calvin Newell, transfer from Oklahoma, lost it. Kaji, great play to knock that ahead of Larkin, who finds a wide open Scott for an easy two. 14 to Rand Scott. Balance, experience, really good defensive team. Maybe underrated as a defensive squad. I like Miami a lot.
No question, Dave. Holding their opponents to 38% from the field. That's tremendous defense. 61 points. So this is a tremendous team. Tell you what, they might be one of the top two teams in the ACC.
Really?
Duke
top
won.
Two?
They could be, yes.
Wow. Wilson feeling it. Long range three. His second triple, timeout Donnie Jones. Nine tonight for Wilson. That's quite a statement, Pete.
Well, Dave, think about it. I know we haven't studied them assiduously. I don't know what the word means, but I know you're very smart. But I think, you like it.
14-11 tonight. Now, speaking of the ACC, five of the last 12 NCAA champs have come from the Atlantic Coast Conference. A loaded league. And as Pete mentioned, the 18 league games this year will make it challenging. We'll see another ACC team Saturday, Florida State at Charlotte.
2 o'clock on CBS Sports Network. Should be fun. Fun for us. I don't know if it'll be fun for the opponent. Charlotte. It's going to be in the Bobcats Arena, Dave, as you know.
That's right. Time Warner Arena in Charlotte. Looking forward to that. Missed by Brown. Here's Newell through traffic. Look at how aggressive Larkin is staying even late in the game. Johnson fights. Rolls around 300 pounds. Tries to corral him. And bound for the ACC, and congratulations. Hey, you lost a lot of those games personally to Jim Boeheim.
Exactly.
900 wins after the victory over Detroit last night, only by 4 points, third ever to get to 900.
Unbelievable coach, great coach, lovely wife there with him, and tremendous coach, very modest guy, and unbelievable career. Only the third coach to do that besides Coach Krzyzewski and Bob Knight, so congratulations, Jim. I went down hard many times against this squad.
How many would you estimate? You beat him a couple times.
Well, we beat him once up at the Dome.
Right.
And we beat him once in Madison Square Garden in the quarterfinals of the Big East tournament. But he probably about 9-2, Jim. And it could have been a lot worse. He felt sorry for me. We stuck in two wins. But he's a great coach, and they have great talent.
Just amazing.
Unreal fans and very esteemed alumni like yourself.
Well, I appreciate that. Entire career coaching at Syracuse. You saw that stat. First win with the Orange, 1976 against Harvard. Kaji, long-range shot. Oh, way off, but he knew it was off, so he has the offensive glass in the paint and lost it. Bob Knight is next up for Jim Boeheim, 902 wins, and coach will get that in a couple games. As they head into their final Big East season, UCF is heading to the Big East. The seven schools we know about, the announcement Saturday, are leaving the Big East. We don't know when. We're not sure what they'll be called when they leave. But,
exactly.
Boy, a lot happening in the college sports landscape these days.
Not shaking. Now we hit a three here. Now we got a 10-point game, Dave. UCF can get a three. Anything can happen.
Sykes thinking about that very thing. Short on a three. Johnson has yet another rebound. 12th board of the night for big Reggie Johnson for Miami.
He's unbelievable.
He is unbelievable.
He dominates the paint offensively and defensively. He's taking their time, Dave. No sense of urgency. The clock's their best friend right now.
Scott and Wilson likes the matchup. Step back. Whoa, it got physical. And he hit the three, and he got mugged by Wilson, but there was no call. Literally steamrolled by Casey Wilson. Somehow hit that shot. Spurlock at a end. Response short. Kaji the rebound. Scott on the move again. Hesitation, Scott. Three-point play. That was spectacular. He's taking over the game. He's hit three threes. He's up to 19. Durant Scott. He might be a first-team All-ACC player this year.
When it comes to the financial obstacles military families face, we understand.
Party in Michigan State won it 67-59. That was the first non-conference win over a top 15-ranked team since 89. For Miami since Kansas, then ranked number 12, a win for Miami. That was a huge victory for them.
Great home victory, beating Tom Izzo and Michigan State now. Game's coming up, Dave. They're playing Hawaii, then they could get Arizona in the second round. LaSalle coming up, a good opponent, and then an ACC play real soon. But they're going to be tough, Dave. I think they're right now the second best team in the ACC as we speak on December 18th.
Scott. Leading the way, one of four double-figure scorers for Miami tonight. Clanton drives, hangs, tries to hit, but he is fouled. A lot of contacts. McKinney Jones and Scott in the vicinity. McKinney Jones picks it up.
Well, plays for the weak at heart. Attacking the basket. McKinney Jones didn't get in there completely. I don't blame him. A runaway train like that, 6'9", 250. I wouldn't get in there either.
So it's Clanton, the senior, from right here in Orlando. An unbelievable game against Bethune-Cookman, 14-15. Was the best in Division I basketball, Pete, since Matt Kingsley of Stephen F. Austin in 2008 went 15-60. That's just a remarkable game for Keith Clanton.
Yeah, he just dominated Bethune-Cookman just with his strength and size and 30 points. Career high, Dave, as you mentioned. So he's a terrific player.
That's a nice roll on that free throw. Still way down here tonight against Miami, the ACC. Larkin, the great court speed, feeds Ryan Brown. Lefty reverse layup, perfect for Brown.
A lot of answers, Dave. Yeah, a very good team on a good night to knock off these Hurricanes.
Spurlock to fake. Dribble drive, baseline. Can't get the roll off the glass. Kenny Jones, the rebound. Scott again off to the races. Durant Scott flies in. Can't lay it in, but the tip for Johnson. Another two for Big Reggie. 16 points, 12 rebounds. Continues to expand on the double-double numbers. Good hands, Larkin. Again, another steal. Oh, these guys are fast. Six steals in the night for the Canes. 12 UCF turnovers. I'm sold. Two games we've seen Miami on the road. Tough test, and they pass with flying colors.
Jackson, very, very good day. Very experienced. Well coached. They got all the ingredients for a great run in the NCAA tournament.
Wilson, the run out. Not close. Led too far by Keith Clanton. 13th turnover of the night. Yikes. Reggie Johnson and Spurlock come together. And, well, Reggie at nearly 300 pounds. Spurlock at 230 pounds.
That's the wall of Johnson you ran into. A big fella.
Reggie has tied his season high with 13 rebounds tonight. He has been everywhere. 5 of 6 from the line. 5 of 8 from the field. And another double-double. Brown off the screen, lost the handle. Williams tried to find it.
UCF ball here. Just finished up that story about Matt Williams Jr. heading out now of the game. And staying out there, number 12 in gold. As Johnson checks out, really an amazing story. A Penix burst while he's watching a team scrimmage. He was raced to the hospital. Donnie Jones visited him every day in the hospital to make sure he recovered all right with the ensuing infection. Man, great to see him back in the court.
Great to have him back.
Here's Larkin. When he came back, Williams had 7 threes in a win over Division II FIT. Not bad. Way to come back after the appendicitis. Final minute. Jakiri can't hit a second field goal of his career. Putback is fouled on the way up. Fouls on Sykes, his fourth. Jakiri, a nice game against Charlotte in the last outing for Miami. Had a couple blocks and 11 minutes of action against the 49ers, both career bests for the freshman. He'll have another tomorrow, 8 Eastern. Don't miss more college hoops. Oregon, the Pac-12, traveling to El Paso. Take on UTEP, only on CBS Sports Network, the 24-hour home of CBS Sports. Last night, UNLV from the Mountain West visiting UTEP. And the Miners nearly came away with a win. Lost a close one at a last-second three for a victory.
Tim Floyd's an outstanding coach, Dave. They're going to get it going. They're playing a tough schedule. They're going to be there. They get a chance to go to postseason. And a very dangerous team, UTEP, as the season wears on.
Jakiri gets the roll in the second free throw. Correll's into the game in the final moments. Dusky is in too. Here's Walker, and he is fouled. Freshman from Philadelphia, won a state title at Constitution High School last year, an all-state player in Pennsylvania. We'll have a couple free throws here in the final moments. With 6 seconds standing between the Canes and another victory, it'll be their 7th of the year and 6th in a row. One more here for Walker. Gets roll on the second. He was the 33rd ranked point guard nationally last year. High school recruiting services. Looks forward to a good future here in Orlando for Donnie Jones. But the present, Miami, very effective tonight. First triple does not get a lot of minutes for Miami in the final seconds here, getting some time. Mark Pajori with the interception, and that will do it for tonight's game. Emphatic resume builder for Jim Larranaga and Miami out of the ACC. We are believers.